Okay guys, so today we are getting Reheat and Repine as two new heroes. So yeah, let's review Reheat first of all. Okay, so yeah, this is his first skill in which he will deal some magical damage to the frontal enemies and it will inflict the Black Moon brand for 3 seconds and hit enemies just cannot recover mana for the duration and it will knock them down for 3 seconds. And yeah, he will deal additional damage according to the per stack of Otherworldly Curse. So yeah, Otherworldly Curse is his passive, we will discuss this later on. Okay, so yeah, here comes the combo part, the second skill, in which both the heroes, that is Reheat and Repine, dispels themselves from the CC effects they are inflicted with and they converts each other's marks. That means the Black Moon inflicted by Reheat and the Silver Moon inflicted by Repine into the Full Moon mark whenever they'll use their second skill. And if the Silver Moon and the Black Moon mark is converted into the Full Moon one, then the Full Moon execution becomes available, which is the additional skill that they got, is activated for 10 seconds. Okay, for example, like if Reheat uses his second skill, he will inflict the Black Moon mark. And if Repine is in your team, and if she uses the second skill, then she'll convert the Black Moon mark to the Full Moon. And then Full Moon execution will be available for 10 seconds, which is their passive. And I'll tell you about the Full Moon execution thing after some time, because we do have to read his passive too. So yeah, let's just get into the third ability now. Okay, so in his third ability, he will deal some magical damage to the frontal enemies for 10 times. And this ability will stun them for 2 seconds. And yeah, after 10 attacks, he will deliver a final blow for the additional magical damage and some additional damage per stack of the Otherworldly Curse. It will ignore enemies' block. Okay, so yeah, let's move on to his passive now, that is Otherworldly Mana, in which he'll be dealing 35% more damage to enemies and he'll get one stack of Otherworldly Curse per each hit of normal as well as the skill hits, and it can be stacked up to 30 times. And with these stacks, like, he'll be dealing more damage in his first and the third abilities to enemies which will ignore their block effect per each stack of Otherworldly Curse. So yeah, that skill is really good for the HP type bosses like Siegfried and Sharkman. Okay, so yeah, let's move on to the new assassin that we have now, that is Repine. Okay, so yeah, let's take a look on her first ability. Okay, so yeah, that's her first ability, in which she'll be dealing some magical damage to the target over 4 times. And yeah, she'll be delivering an additional attack which will deal some magical damage, and that attack will stun the target for 2 seconds. And the last hit will deal additional magical damage that will ignore defense per stack of the Otherworldly Curse. Okay, so yeah, let's move on to the second ability of Repine. This ability is same as the Reheat one, and I have already told you about this ability. The only difference is, like, for the second ability of Repine, she'll be going to the farthest enemy and she'll inflict the Silver Moon mark. That's the only difference. Like, I have already told you about the combination of these two, so you can refer the video on the first or second minute when I was telling you about the second ability of Reheat, and you will be knowing, like, how their combo will work. And yeah, like, they'll target each other's marked enemy. So, like, for example, Repine inflicts the Silver Moon mark, so Reheat's skills will be targeted to the enemy which is already inflicted with the Silver Moon mark. So yeah, I'm just not going in depth because you guys will get confused. So yeah, we'll just discuss about their abilities when I'll be streaming. Okay, so yeah, let's move on to the third ability of hers, that is, in the third ability, she'll be attacking the enemy 5 times and dealing some of the magical damage. And yeah, the final attack will be dealing some more magical damage which will ignore the defense per stack of the Otherworldly Curse. And yeah, remember, like, Otherworldly Curse can be stacked up to max 30 times. So yeah, let's move on to the final passive. Okay, so yeah, this is the ability like I was talking about when I was discussing both of their second ability, in which they converts each other's marks into the full moon mark. And this additional skill becomes available for use for 10 seconds, in which they'll dispel themselves from CC effects and perform a combo attack, in which they will hit the full moon marked enemy multiple times for some damage, and the last hit explodes the full moon mark, dealing some more damage. And the damage dealt by Raheet ignores block effects, and if this damage is dealt by Repine, it will ignore the enemy's defense. So yeah, this is the massive damage combo skill, especially when the target is not a hero. And this skill is performed by Raheet and Repine both. So you need both of them in your team. You just can't perform this skill when you have either Raheet or Repine in your team. You just need both of them to cast this ability. Okay guys, this is it for the new heroes, and if you still have any doubt regarding their abilities or perks or which UT to select for them, make sure to join me on my stream and sub to my channel. Make sure to click that bell icon so that you will be notified when I'm going to stream. And yeah, now I'm going to test them further in my Cecilia main account. So if you like the video, make sure to like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys soon. Have a nice day, boys.